In this topic, you will consider how you can leverage unstructured storage using cloud storage. Cloud storage is just one of the many storage options on GCP and stores and serves object data, also known as blob data. You can store an unlimited amount of objects in the cloud, up to 5 terabytes in size each. Cloud storage is well suited for binary or object data such as images, media servings, and backups. Cloud storage is the same storage that we use for images in Google Photos, Gmail attachments, Google Docs, and so on. Users have a variety of storage requirements for a multitude of use cases. To cater to these requirements, we offer different classes of cloud storage. The classes are based on how often the data is accessed. Multi-regional storage costs a bit more, but it's geo-redundant. That means you pick a broad geographical location like the United States, the European Union, or Asia, and cloud storage stores your data in at least 2 geographic locations separated by at least 160 kilometers. This option is ideal for storing data that is frequently accessed around the world, such as serving website content, streaming videos, or gaming and mobile applications. Regional storage lets you store your data in a specific GCP region, for example, US Central 1, Europe West 1, or Asia East 1. It's cheaper than multi-regional storage, but it offers less redundancy. This option is ideal for data analytics and machine learning jobs. Nearline Storage is a low-cost, highly durable storage service for storing infrequently accessed data. This storage class is a better choice than multi-regional storage or regional storage in scenarios where you plan to read or modify your data on average once a month or less. For example, if you want to continuously add files to cloud storage and plan to access these files once a month for analysis, Nearline Storage is a great choice. Typical uses for this storage class include long-tail content, multimedia source, file storage, and online backups. Codeline Storage is a very low-cost, highly durable storage service for data archiving, online backups, and disaster recovery. Codeline Storage is the best choice for data that you plan to access at most once a year. Due to this slightly lower availability, 90-day minimum storage duration, cost for data access, and higher pre-operational cost. Typical use cases include archive data, data with lengthy storage durations from legal or regulatory requirements, tape migrations, and disaster recovery. Cloud storage is unique in a number of ways. It has a single API, milliseconds data access latency, and 11 nines durability across all storage classes. Cloud storage also offers object lifecycle management, which uses policies to automatically move data to lower cost storage classes as it is accessed less frequently throughout its life. Cloud storage files are organized into buckets. When you create a bucket, you give it a globally unique name. You specify a geographic location where the bucket and its contents are stored, and you choose one of the default storage classes that you were introduced to earlier. There are several ways to control users' access to your objects and buckets. For most purposes, Cloud IAM is sufficient. Roles are inherited from project to bucket to object. If you need finer control, you can create access control lists. ACLs define who has access to your bucket and objects, as well as what level of access they have. Each ACL consists of 2 pieces of information: a scope, which defines who can perform the specified actions, and a permission, which defines what action can be performed, for example, read or write. If you want, you can turn on object versioning on your buckets. Cloud storage keeps a history of modifications, that is, overrides or deletes, for all objects in the bucket. You can list the archived versions of an object, restore an object to an older state, or permanently delete a version as needed. If you don't turn on object versioning, new always overrides old. Cloud storage also offers lifecycle management policies. For example, you could tell cloud storage to delete objects older than 365 days, or to delete objects created before January 1st, 2013. or to keep only the three most recent versions of each object in a bucket that has versioning enabled.